Guys, welcome back to the channel. Hope you guys are doing good. So in the last video, we discussed about the lumbar vertebrae and their characteristics. Today's video is long, so without wasting any more time, let's jump right into it. But wait, what are we studying today? Let me count the vertebrae and tell you today's topic. 1, 2, 3. Oh yes, so today we have to study the fourth type of vertebrae, that is sacral vertebrae. So let's see the three-dimensional structure of sacrum. And here it is. Though this is the dorsal surface of sacrum, we'll discuss later on about the dorsal view. First, let's discuss some basics about the sacrum. Sacrum is a large flattened bone formed by the fusion of 5 sacral vertebrae. Sacrum transmits the body weight to the hip bone. It forms the posterior part of bony pelvis. And yeah, pelvis is the region between the abdomen and the thighs. And next, it articulates on each side with corresponding hip bone to form the sacroiliac joint. Basically, sacrum has a base, an apex, pelvic surface, and dorsal surface. Let's discuss each of these parts separately. So first we have is the base. The upper massive part of the sacrum is the base. Sacrum has superior articular processes which articulate with the fifth lumbar vertebra to form the lumbosacral joint. The projecting anterior margin of this articulation is called as the promontory. Yeah, a little bit unusual word, but that's what it is. This is the superior view of sacrum. This is the upper massive part of sacrum, the body. These are superior articular processes on each side. Now let's see the promontory separately. So this is the sacrum articulated with the hip bones, and this projecting margin which you can see is the promontory. Next we come to the apex. It bears a facet on it for articulation with the coccyx or the coccygeal vertebrae. We'll discuss the coccygeal vertebrae in the next video. For now, let's see the coccygeal vertebrae. These are the coccygeal vertebrae that attaches with the apex of the sacrum. So this is the sacrum without the coccyx attached, and this is the apex where the coccygeal vertebrae articulates. We come to the third aspect of sacrum, that is the pelvic surface. Firstly, this surface is smooth and concave. The median of this surface is marked by 4 transverse ridges, and these transverse ridges indicate the line of fusion of body of 5 sacral vertebrae. The transverse ridges end on each side at the anterior sacral foramen, and these foramen communicate with the sacral canal. Too complicated to hear, right? But it's not difficult at all. Let's see these parts. So this is the pelvic surface of sacrum, and as you can see, it is smooth and concave. We take the first part which we discussed, that it has 4 transverse ridges. So these are the 4 transverse ridges present on the pelvic surface. Next, we discuss that they end at each side at the anterior sacral foramen. So these are those foramen. And these foramen communicate with the sacral canal, which we will see later on because it will be visible better from the dorsal aspect of sacrum. So which is the next surface? Next we have is the dorsal surface. Firstly, the dorsal surface is irregular and convex. The midline is marked by median sacral crest, and it represents the fusion of bodies of upper 4 sacral vertebrae. Lateral to the median sacral crest, we see the intermediate sacral crest, which are formed by fused articular process of the sacral vertebrae. And lateral to the intermediate sacral crest, we have another crest, which is the lateral sacral crest, formed by fused transverse processes of the sacral vertebrae. Between the intermediate and lateral sacral crest, we have the posterior sacral foramen, and it communicates with the sacral canal. Also, these foramen separate the intermediate part from the lateral part. Listening to the lateral part, I got another point about it. The lateral part of sacrum has the auricular surface, and this surface articulates with the ilium and the sacral tuberosity. The inferior articular process of fifth sacral vertebra are free and these form the sacral corno. Corno is a Latin term and it means horn in English. The sacral corno projects downwards from the sides of the sacral hiatus. And again, hiatus is a Latin term for the word opening. So much theoretical terms. But hey, don't worry, these are as simple as the pelvic surface. So let's see these parts. This is the dorsal surface, which we saw in the starting of the video. And this is the median sacral crest. Lateral to this, we have this intermediate sacral crest. And lateral to the intermediate sacral crest, we have this lateral sacral crest. Between these crests, we have the posterior sacral foramen, which are right here. This is the lateral view of sacrum. This L-shaped surface is the auricular surface that articulates with the ilium and sacral tuberosity. Let's again see the dorsal surface to see the parts left. This is the sacral corno and this projects downwards from the sides of this opening, the sacral hiatus. And lastly, we have the sacral canal. So that wraps up the whole sacrum. I know today's video is long, but I can't help it, I had to explain it. So yeah, hope you guys understood today's topic. Thanks for watching guys, have a nice day.